This is how Tesla's version 11 software will look like. This is actually just a render done by someone online and who posted it on Reddit, so I will be using their images, and if you want to see those images and the entire Reddit post, the link will be down below the like button. Wow, this video is gonna age terribly because tonight is the Plaid event. But anyways, let's just start looking at the first image. So here we just see an overlay of the version 11 software. We can see that there's maps on the top left. You can see that there are settings on the bottom left, and on the entire right side of the screen, pretty much you got your music settings and everything else right there. And you can see on the complete left side where you see the car, that's probably how you shift gears. With the new Model S and X, you can actually just swipe up and down and you'll shift gears. You want to go into reverse, I think you just swipe up. If you want to go and drive, you just swipe down, something like that. Then at the bottom, you obviously have your heated seats, your climate controls, and everything else, and the temperature is set to 69 degrees. Nice. And then on the bottom right, you got volume controls. This is obviously just a rendering, but this person, whoever he is or she is, have done an incredible job with this rendering. It looks great, it looks beautiful, and I really can't wait for the new software. Now in the next image, it looks almost the same, except there's some sort of tab that you pull down on from the top, like just swipe down, and you basically get this entire row of apps. So you could do like music, Apple Music apparently, Netflix, Waze, Robinhood, Zoom, Google Maps, karaoke, or karaoke I should have said. But basically, what is this supposed to do? I think Tesla is finally bringing in an app store. If you watch my last video, I'll be linked right here. I talked about the Cybertruck, and if you see in their patents, in their UI, it kind of looks like that they're gonna be including an app store, and the Cybertruck will be coming out later this year. This is just coming out maybe a few months early, version 11. It's already basically mid-2021 right now. This could be really promising. So in this next image, it actually shows you the app drawer. You can see your most used entertainment, music and podcasts, and your travel apps. This is gonna be a big deal because now you have a screen which you can pretty much launch whatever apps you want and just start playing games on it, launch your apps that you want, you launch Waze, I don't know, maybe trade on Robinhood, who knows, whatever you wanna do, you can do that now. Or at least hopefully that's what Tesla will be bringing out in the version 11 software. Clearly, I don't know about it right now. So if you're watching this video later in the future and version 11 is already out, this would be hilariously outdated. So in the next render, we have something that looks like a video call. Now in a Tesla, you actually have a cabin camera. If you look at the rear view mirror, right above that, there's actually a small little camera. So what they could do is implement a video calling feature just like Zoom or something and allow access or allow the users access to access that camera. What that would do is say you're just driving, or even if you're not driving, you're just parked somewhere, you can actually have video conferences with, say, your colleagues, family and friends, and whatnot. And basically you just see that exact here. So you see the cabin camera showing the person's face. Maybe they can do like a smart zoom in that Apple has been showing off with their new iPad, because it's so wide angle, they can actually zoom into a person's face. So maybe she'll only show the driver and then zoom out for everyone based on how the audio comes out. And then you see Elon on the call, and then you see this pretty lady. So there's that. And then you see the weather, Austin, Texas, 69 degrees, nice. And then you see the songs down at the bottom right, and everything else is pretty much the same. It looks pretty good in my opinion. I guess the ones on the right are just gonna be the widgets that you can use in the future, or maybe perhaps even right now. So in this image, we see that you can probably create a smart stack, whatever that actually means. And basically, if you just hold on it, you can actually move the icons around and probably move them around to different widget, different places, and just create it so it's like a home screen for your phone and just make it like that. Teslas are literally becoming the smartphone. So here, the next page is not that much different. It's just in dark mode. And personally, I love this dark mode for the win. Video conferencing, and then you got Robinhood over there, and you also got your Spotify playing down at the bottom right. It's gonna look really good. Again, just another image with your dark mode and the app stacks, whatever you wanna call it, basically your app drawer. And here's how it would look if it's on the screen, on the Tesla screen. And personally, this guy has done an incredible job at like masking everything. Maybe it's a real image, who knows, but it looks incredible. It looks really beautiful. And then the last image right here is again the mock-up of your Plex browser and with the apps that you can see at the top. And so yeah, that's pretty much just your version 11 and the UI, how it will look, how it will probably perform. And if you want way more details about it, the guy has actually like listed everything properly in a nice readable format that you'll actually understand what is actually happening. And he explains it in a nice way as well, so you could probably easily understand. So the link will be right below the like button if you want to go check it out, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Peace.